Hello students, now in this lecture today we are going to study about the something more about the manures. Okay, now yesterday we have discussed, in the last lecture we have discussed, we have learned many things about the manures, why we should use it, what are the advantages of using it, and in fact even the disadvantages. Okay, now can we use something else? Can anything else can take place, takes the place of manures? Okay, so what it is or what it can be, the first name which comes is fertilizers. Okay, so just what is fertilizer? Again, it is also a sort of a chemical which increases the fertility of the soil, which helps the farmers to get a better quality crop, to get the even the quantity can be increased. Okay, so just have a look here, we will be looking about the advantages and disadvantages of the fertilizers, or rather we can study even in a comparative way, like what are manures and what are fertilizers, and then we can even have a look, we can understand that why manures should be used, or even if there's someone like, you know, some farmers, they go for the fertilizers. So just we can understand the difference between the two, and we can also understand the good and bad part of both the things. Okay, so to begin with, we will study the difference between manures and fertilizers. Okay, so we have studied a lot about the manures in the last lecture, and I'm sure now we know that what actually manures are. Okay, so what manures are? It is a natural substance. Okay, it is what? It is a natural substance. It is a natural substance formed, even I can write natural compounds or natural, like the manures are the, whenever we talk about manure, it has to be natural. Okay, so natural substances formed by the decomposition of organic matter. Okay, and here what are fertilizers? These are okay. So when we talk about fertilizers, what are fertilizers? Fertilizers are inorganic compound. Okay, fertilizers are inorganic compound formed by using certain chemicals. Okay, so what I have written over here, natural substance, manure are what? Natural substance. Okay, we can even write it is an organic substance formed by the organic decomposition. Okay, so natural substance formed by the decomposition of organic matter. Okay, now decomposition means what? Like when the, we have studied yesterday also, like when the dead and decomposed, like when dead thing or the natural waste, maybe cow dung, maybe the fodder, the leftover of the fodders, maybe the plant leftovers. Okay, when all these are allowed to, or it is kept for some time, it get like some microbes start working upon that and break them into smaller and smaller particle, which becomes the part of the soil again. Okay, that means it is getting broken up, it is getting divided into smaller smaller particles and becoming the part of the soil, or even we can say that it is getting decomposed. Okay, so what is happening when the natural substances are broken up, it get decomposed. Okay, so what is formed? Manure is formed. When we talk about fertilizers, what are fertilizers? Inorganic compounds. Okay, that the main difference is that it is organic compound, and here it is what? Inorganic compound formed by the, now here we are not using any kind of decomposition, okay, no decomposition is there. It is formed by using certain chemicals. Now this word has to be underlined. That means the biggest difference is what? It is formed by the natural substance. It is formed by the decomposition of the natural things, and these are fertilizers are being made by the chemicals. Okay, so this is the biggest difference. Okay, now the second thing, when I'm saying this is a natural, okay, it is a natural thing, it is, it can be made naturally, so obviously it can be made, it can be made by the farmers in the field itself. Okay, and here is made in the factories. Okay, so as we have discussed this thing like earlier also, like this is formed by the decomposition of natural thing, and all these natural things which is required for the formation of manure is available in the where? In the field. It is there with the farmers. So what is the case? It can be made by the farmers in the field itself. But this can't be made by the farmers, okay, this is made in the factories. Now when the farmers are making it, okay, when it is made by themselves without, you know, without putting, like they don't have to put lot of money into that, okay. So what can be the third point? It can be like it is cheaper. Okay, it is cheaper, it is not very costly, and it is costly. Okay, so it is like we, the farmers don't have to put so like much of money over here, but if one has to buy fertilizers, he has to have money with him. So it is cheap and it is costly. Okay, now the next one is, now these are heavy or bulky, okay, and so don't get dissolved easily in the water. And here it get dissolved easily. Okay, now see, this is little bit bulky, okay, it doesn't get easily dissolved in the water. See, we all know it is made up of cow dung, some waste, so all this thing get dissolved in the water, but not as faster as the fertilizers get dissolved. Okay, so what is there? It is heavy and it bulky, and so do not get easily dissolved into water, but here it get dissolved into water very easily. Now when I am saying that it is not getting dissolved easily, and so it's difficult to write down, don't get, okay, it is not absorbed, I'll write in short, oh, it's no place over there, okay, so next I can write over here, don't get, yeah, there is no place to write. Okay, So the fifth point is not get absorbed properly. Okay, what is the meaning of properly? Specially want to mention over here, it get absorbed but it is time consuming. Okay, it doesn't get absorbed very soon. Okay, so not get absorbed soon or properly, it get absorbed very soon. Okay, so as it doesn't get dissolved into water, so again the absorption also becomes like slower. Okay, it gets slower, and here it get absorbed very like very fast. It is a fast process. Now I'll have to continue over here. Manures and fertilizers okay. So when I'm saying it is not getting dissolved easily, it is not getting absorbed easily, okay, that means what? It is a time consuming process, which we have studied yesterday also. That means, see, both the cases are there. In the formation, in the making of manure also, like it takes lot of time, okay, and in the absorption also it takes lot of time, and so in the result also it shows like it is a it takes lot of time. Okay, so what I can write, I can write here it takes time to show results. Okay, gives fast results. Okay, now the formation is also very time consuming. So forming or formation, or I can write making. Okay, formation or making is also time consuming. Okay, and here I can write, as it is made in factories, it is done very fast. It's not time consuming. Okay, it is not time consuming. Now again a very important point, you know, like it is not nutrient specific. It is not nutrient specific, and this one is nutrient specific. Okay, it is nutrient specific. Okay, now what is the meaning of this? See, it is not nutrient specific. See, when we are adding manures, whenever I'm saying we are, that means I'm talking about the farmers only. Okay, so when the farmers are adding manure to the soil in the land, what is happening? It is not the case like the field is deficient of any particular element, maybe nitrogen, maybe anything, phosphorus. So when the manure is added, the farmers know that this particular manure is not going to remove nitrogen deficiency. Okay, like it is going to remove, but at the same time what will happen, it is going to improve, it is going to give a better texture, better, like the overall nutrient will be given to the soil. Okay, so it gives the overall nutrients, and this is a very nutrient specific. Okay, now ninth one, it provides humus to the soil. It do not provide, okay, it do not provide. What do not provide? Humus. Okay, now see, It provides humus to the soil. Now, what is humus? Humus is like what? When the dead and decompose, like when the things get dead and decompose, it becomes full of nutrients, and that is given. It reaches to the soil, and the overall fertility of the soil get increased. Okay, so I can write over here improves texture. Okay, here rather it spoils the texture. Okay, it is eco-friendly. It 10th. Okay, this one is 10, children. This one is 11. It pollutes the. I'm writing in very short. It pollutes the atmosphere. I'll just explain this. Okay, now overall, now see what is happening. We were here, it is not providing a particular specific nutrient, but it is overall improving the quality of the soil. It is improving the texture of the soil. Okay, now this is very, very important part. When I'm saying it is improving the texture of the soil, it is providing humus to the soil. Okay, so it is improving texture of the soil. So what is happening? The overall quality of the soil becomes good. Okay, the soil can now the farmers can get the crops of the better quality, and even the quantity will be increased. Okay, so what is happening over here with the fertilizers? When we talk about, it is not going to provide any kind of humus to the soil. Okay, and at the same time, like, why it is not providing humus to the soil? Because see, it is made up of the chemicals. Okay, and chemicals are, and that too also, like, it is very nutrient specific. It will give a particular nutrient. If we talk about nitrogen, so that particular fertilizer will be used by the farmer, and that particular soil, that particular land will become rich in that nutrient. Okay, now it improves the texture. I have written here spoil. I should not write it directly, but it rather, when we talk in long term, fertility of the soil. It spoils the texture of the soil. Okay, now eco-friendly. See, eco-friendly means what? We all know, actually, it is now, we all are very, very familiar to this word. Eco-friendly means what? It is environmental friendly. That means it is not harming the nature. Okay, so it can be used on the large extent. Now, when I say it pollutes the atmosphere, okay, so in what way it is polluting? See, first of all, it is polluting the land, because it is reducing. When we talk about the long term, if the fertilizers are used on the long, for a longer period, so what happened? The fertility also get decreased. Okay, first thing, why the fertility get decreased? Because the soil, now soil, the texture of the soil is not so good. The nutrients in the soil are not so good now. Okay, like, it is not left with the nutrients. And then in the next chapter, in the proceeding, like in the further chapters, we'll be reading about the pollution, the land pollution, how the fertilizers, they pollute even the water. Okay, they pollute the river water. Why? Because when the fertilizers are sprayed or added to the soil, and when it rains, along with the rainwater, the fertilizer get mixed up with the rainwater, and this rainwater again in due course of time, it get mixed up with the water, and it pollutes the water. It is not only polluting the sand, it is polluting the water, and even these fertilizers are very, very harmful for the microbes, or the, you know, helpful microbes, the important microbes, okay, which are there in the soil. In fact, it also, if you know something about my bioification, you know, but it will be of high level, so we'll just skip it out. So, you know, when the, see, in short, I'll just tell you, like, grains are eaten by the, suppose, rats. Okay, now rats are eaten by the snake, like when we talk about the food chain. So this fertilizers, in due course of time, it goes, it reaches to the highest level also. Okay, that means on the highest level of the chain, that means it reaches in the body of the animals also. Okay, so it is, the fertilizers are rather very, very harmful. Okay, so we'll just have a quick look on whatever things we have read over here, the difference between the manure and the fertilizer. So when we talk about manures, what are manures? Manures are the substance, like it is organic substance. How it is made? It is made by the decomposition of the all natural things. Okay, maybe cow dung, maybe cow urine, maybe the fodders, leftover fodders, okay, whatever left thing is there, maybe the residues of plant and the dead parts, the dead leaves of the plants. So all these things can be added and the manure can be made. Now we talk about fertilizers. Fertilizers are made by what? Chemicals. Okay, next is it can be made by the farmers only, like when the farmers, they themselves are making it and it can be made in the field. So it is very very cheaper and when we compare it with the fertilizers, because fertilizers are made in the factories. Okay, now these are like, it doesn't get dissolved easily into the water. Okay, I am combining the two points. It doesn't get dissolved into water and so it like it get absorbed by the plants, but it takes little time. Okay, so the absorption also takes little time. Now here it get readily dissolved, like very easily dissolved in water, and so it is absorbed by the plants very like in a very within few minutes. Okay, now here it takes time, like I'm telling it again I'm saying it, okay, it is a time consuming process. It takes time to make manure. Okay, so making is time consuming. Okay, and so absorption is a time consuming process over here, and so results also, it takes little time to show the to see the results, but this one fertilizers are very fast, you know. Now this one, when we talk about, it is very important point, nutrient specific. Manures are not at all nutrient specific, but fertilizers are nutrient specific. Okay, now the next is what? It improves the texture, it gives humus to the soil, it doesn't give, and it spoils the texture of the soil, and it is eco-friendly, it doesn't pollute, and it pollutes the atmosphere. Okay, examples also we can write, maybe urea. Okay, there is no place to write now. Urea, ammonia, potash. So all these are what? These are examples of fertilizers. Okay, so see, both the things are there. We have advantages of also of manure also, and disadvantages are also there of manure. What can be the advantages? Advantages, so the biggest advantage is it improves the fertility of the soil, it provides humus to the soil, in long term it give all the nutrients which is required. Okay, and the soil in long term, the quality and the quantity of the crop get what? Improved. Okay, these all are advantages. It is cheap, this is also advantage, it can be made by farmers, again an advantage. But when we talk about the disadvantages of the manure, what? It is a time consuming process, it takes time to show the results. Okay, so it is bulky, do not get dissolved easily. Now when we talk about fertilizers, what can be the advantage of fertilizer? Fast, it is very very fast. Okay, the doesn't take much time to be made in the factories, get dissolved in the water very easily, get absorbed by the plants very easily. Okay, and it is nutrient specific, so nice. Like particular field is deficient of nitrogen, just the farmer said the particular say fertilizer which provides the nitrogen to the soil. So it is very fast. Okay, and it is nutrient specific. But again, what are the disadvantages? The biggest disadvantage is that it pollutes the atmosphere like anything. It is harmful for not only men, but it is harmful for the animals who eat this. It is harmful for the microbes, it is harmful for the like rivers. So it is very very harmful. Okay, so you know, if you can try this thing, if you do a small experiment. Okay, which kind of experiment? If you take I'll just show it over here. If we take three pods. Okay, in these three pods, if you put everything, like you know, same soil and whatever is required for the growth of the plant. But what one thing we have to do, obviously you have to put sapling also. Okay, don't forget to do that. So in this, a plant is planted And here even you can put some seeds also. If you don't want to put the plant, you can add some seeds into this three pots, okay, A, B and C. Now what should be the difference? In the pot A we won't be adding anything, nothing is added in the pot A, okay. So pot A nothing is there. Pot B I have added manure, okay, and in pot C fertilizer, okay, and we'll just allow it to, like, we all the things, other things should be same, same amount of sunlight, same place, same type of amount seed should be used, same amount of water has to be given, okay. Then wait for the results. After some time you will find if you have added seeds, okay, so you will find the seeds are germinating, okay. But what will happen, you will find that in A, it depends on A wala, it will depends upon the soil, the quality of soil which you have taken, normal growth. B, it will be showing better growth than the A. Why? Because that extra nutrients are being added obviously in the B, okay. But when we talk about C, we have added fertilizers in that. So guess what will happen? Obviously the growth will be faster, okay. When the growth will be faster, and even though if you had added seeds to this, so the number of seeds which will come out will be more, okay. So this will be the difference. When you are not adding manure, growth is totally normal, and if you keep on growing the crops in the same pot, a day will come when you won't be able to get any kind of you won't see germination also. But because all the nutrients are being used, okay, it is used by the seeds again, because we are sowing the seeds again. But when talk about B, when we add manure, it will be obviously better than the A. That means it is going to show better growth than the A. And when we talk about C, where we are adding fertilizers, so in this case what will happen, faster growth will be seen, okay. So how this was just a comparison about the manures and the fertilizers, okay. Now how these manures and fertilizers has to be given, it can be dissolved into the water and can be given can be added in the channels, okay. Channels means from where the water is going to the particular crop, particular area. So there, when before giving the water, this manures can be dissolved, even the fertilizers can be dissolved and can be given through the channels. Second thing about, when we talk about manure fertilizer, see, manure can be just spread, like it cannot be spreaded just like this because it is bulky. So it has to be added in the crop only, it has to be put like this only, okay. Now it has to be mixed up with the soil properly. One thing I told in the beginning of the chapter, that sometimes in some fields, some farmers, what they do, they mix the manure in the, that the manure in the beginning only, okay, when the tilling is going on, okay, when they have to put the seed, before that only some farmers add the manure to the seed or fertilizers to the seed, okay. Now fertilizers can be spread like spraying, okay. So it can be can be given to the plants in this way also, okay. So one more method, like broadcasting, I told you before also, like in olden days the seed used to be broadcasted. That means what, it just used to be spreaded, thrown like this. So even the sometime even the fertilizers can be just thrown like this, but it is again not a very safer method, because the amount at one place it can be more and the other place it can be less, okay. You know, sometimes, you know what happens, this is a personal experience which I am sharing, one of my friend, he deals with this fertilizers and all this thing, okay. So somehow the company made the fertilizers, a new kind of fertilizer was launched into the market, and it was, I don't know what was wrong with that fertilizer, but that it burned all the fields. That particular, when we talk about the village, the particular villagers, they all lost their field, okay. So then lot of things were done, like compensation was given and lot many things happened. But just wanted to tell that compensation part is not important, but this what I wanted to say, ki if the quantity is given more, okay, or the fertilizer is not appropriate, it can even burn the crops, okay. So it can even give rise to the burning. Okay, now we will go to the next topic. Okay. Okay, now this was about the okay. So this was like just now we read about the manures and fertilizer. Okay, that means we are adding something to the soil. Some extra is being added to the soil. But can there be any natural method? Can there be anything by which we can increase the fertility of the soil? Okay, so there are certain natural method also. Okay, natural method. Of what it is, natural methods to increase the fertility of the soil. Okay, I can write even natural methods for increasing the fertility of the soil. Okay. So natural method means what? Means we are not adding anything to it, just by using certain, you know, one or the other ways the fertility of the soil can be brought to normal or can be increased. Okay, so the first one can be leaving the field fallow. Okay, second can be crop rotation. Third can be multiple cropping. Okay, so what we are studying now? We are studying about the natural methods of increasing the fertility of the soil. Okay, before that, what we have discussed? We have discussed a lot about what? Manures and fertilizers, that by using manures and fertilizers, how the fertility of the soil can be increased. Now, leaving the field fallow, what does it mean? It means to leave the field empty, okay, to leave the field empty or uncultivated. Okay, means what? To leave the field empty or uncultivated means what? Means the particular part of land is left uncultivated, that means no crops has to be sown on that particular field, that particular area, that particular land, and it has to be kept like that only for maybe one season, two seasons. Okay, likewise. So what is the use of that? See, like suppose this is a area where we are using this area, this land, for growing the crops again and again. Now, if this part is used again and again, we are growing crops again and again, okay, so that particular amount which is present of the nutrients, okay, the particular nutrients which are present in the soil will obviously be used up with the plants, and then a stage will come when the soil will become nutrient deficient. Means it won't be having enough amount of nutrients to supply to the plants, and definitely it is going to affect the growth of the crops, it is going to affect the quality of the crops, it is going to affect the quantity of the crops. This will be like what? Just take the example of petrol and diesel. If you keep on digging, if you keep on using the petrol and diesel, as we all know, a stage will come when we won't be having any kind of petrol and diesel. Okay, no petrol and diesel will be left on the in the surface of the earth. In the same way, if a particular land is cultivated, okay, n number of times, so what will happen? All the nutrients will be absorbed. It will be a continuous process. So what will happen? Nothing is being added to the soil. Only we are taking. Okay, so the particular part of the land will become deficient of the nutrients. So fallow, leaving the field fallow means what? To leave the field empty, to leave the field uncultivated That means no crops has to be sown on that particular land for a season or two, okay? So then what will happen? It give rise to the natural addition of the nutrients. That means the now after leaving the soil fallow, after a particular time, after a few seasons, when the crop will be grown again, the soil will be ready for and it will be having nutrients, okay? So we can even define it, what is the meaning of leaving the field fallow. That means to leave the field. See, in science always remember one thing, like whatever, whenever you are writing papers, do write that definition. Any descriptive answer is also there, but still write, always start with some, you know, definition. You have to define that, okay? And also try to give more and more examples. This is the first important thing of the science when you write a science paper, okay? So how can we define leaving the field fallow? That means to leave the field empty or uncultivated for a season or two, okay? For a season or two, so that the natural fertility of soil can be increased, okay? So this is about leaving the field fallow, to leave the field empty or uncultivated for a season or two so that the natural fertility of soil can be increased, okay? Moving on to the next one, crop rotation. Now what is the meaning of C? Use logics, okay? Crop and rotation means what? In the school also we have rotation of the benches, yes? Like the one who sits on the first bench will be going one by one, it will be going, the students will be moving to the second and third and fourth, and again it is going to come on the first bench after some time. Same is with the crop rotation. The difference is that here students are not rotating, but the crops are rotating. So rotation means what? To grow different kind of crops alternately on the same field. Okay, what is there? To grow different kind of crops. Okay, remember this, to grow different kind of crops alternately on the same field. Okay, again one word is also used, alternately. That means what? Now in this here, this piece of field, if legume is grown, okay, what is the meaning of legume? Leguminous crop, okay? So leguminous part of all the kind of pulses comes under this category. So we suppose if legume is grown over here in the field, for say like first crop is legume, then the other crop can be wheat. Okay, why and what it is? See, legumes, we all know that in the nodules of the legumes, a bacteria named rhizobium is there. Okay, now which bacteria is there? Rhizobium bacteria is there. Which is there? Rhizobium. Okay, in the nodules of legumes, rhizobium bacteria is there, which has the capacity of nitrogen fixation. Okay, nitrogen fixation, that means what? It fixes the atmospheric nitrogen. So when once when legumes are grown, due to rhizobium bacteria, nitrogen will be available in the soil, and when next time wheat is sown, this nitrogen will be available to the wheat. Okay, so one time a crop A is grown and the another time the crop B is grown, the third time again A is grown, then again B is grown. This is what is about the crop rotation. That means to grow different kind of crops, to grow, okay, different kind of crops. Which are the different kind? Legume and wheat. Okay, these are the different kind of crop. I just want to tell you one thing, ki particular, you know, like in a higher classes we will study that for the crop rotation the whole pairs are being made, and the farmers don't allow the legumes to, like they don't again sow the same A crop just to explain this, you will read this in higher classes that what farmers do, they made the pairs and they sow the crops in this way, that legume once they have sown, it won't come again for a long period of time. Okay, that means different crops will be sown. By the time again the legume comes, again the nutrients which is required for the legume becomes available in the soil. So to read with this, to grow different kind of crops, which crops we have taken? Legumes and wheat. So different kinds of crops we are talking about, grow alternately. This means one time we are growing crop A, legume. Second time we are growing the crop B, that is wheat, on the same field. That means I am not talking about the two different fields, that on A field some A crop is grown and B field B crop is grown. No, on the same field two crops are grown in an alternate way, alternate manner, and so what happens? It adds to the nutrients to the soil. Okay, now what is multiple cropping? Now multiple cropping is what? When different kind of crops, okay, when multiple crops are grown on the same field, in the same field, when different kind of or different kind of crops are grown all together. Now please try to understand the difference between the two. Here we are sowing it alternately, okay. That means at one time if we have legume plants, legume crops, the other season, the other time will be having wheat, okay. Now what is the case with multiple cropping in one field only? We don't have only legumes, we don't have only wheat, we have multiple crops, okay. Multiple crops, like the idea is also like very interesting. Why? Because see, sometimes suppose one crop is eaten or is destroyed or attacked by the pest, maybe destroyed due to some other reasons, okay. So at least the farmers have different crop to rely on, okay. So economically also, like they are not totally lost, they have something in their hand. So this is the one aspect. Second, see, in all this, when we are talking about all this, I would like to write some advantages also over here. Okay, we'll manage over here only. Advantages of all this. Why we need to do it? Okay. What can be the advantages? See, for everything, even when your mama says something, you have a question. Why? Eat this? Why? You know, why to eat such kind of like boring sabzi sometimes? Maybe some soya beans or something which you don't like. So why to eat it? So your mama always gives you some good answer. So why to use all these things? Why? What has to be? What can be the benefits of this? So first is it increases the first is it increases I'll have to rub the blackboard only. Just wait. Okay. So, like we have to read now advantages, why we have to use all these things, okay. So, what can be the advantages, why we have to use all these things, which thing, like living the field fallow, crop rotation, multiple cropping, why it has to be used. So, we'll just have a look